morning, friends. Today we are going to discuss very important aspect of communication, that is, what is communication. This topic is prescribed for our syllabus for BSc and BCom first year students. Friends, first of all, while discussing about this topic, what is communication, we will discuss what is the definition of communication. Generally, communication is an exchange of ideas, thoughts, feelings between two or more than two persons. It means for proper communication, there are two persons needed. One is sender, second one that is receiver. But there are another aspects of communication, another items of communication which can be included in communication process. We will discuss about these items, these contents in detail here. For that purpose, we have to discuss what is communication process. My friends, the communication process with the receiver, that is why this procedure is taking place. Okay, then Sixth one, that is decoding. Then what is decoding? As the process of encoding takes place in the mind of sender, in the same way, the process of decoding takes place in the mind of receiver. Here, receiver has to interpret the message given by the sender. When this receiver interprets the message, he can understand the meaning of message, he can give proper feedback to sender, and that is why the last step of communication process is the feedback. 7-1 feedback. Here, the receiver has to give proper feedback to the sender. After that, sender can understand whether the receiver have understood the message or not. So, after receiving message from the sender, the receiver has to give proper feedback to the receiver. Feedback is the response given by the receiver to the sender, and this is communication process method. If this process continues constantly continues, it is called as communication cycle. Communication cycle means after completion of this process, after feedback by the receiver to the sender, then receiver becomes sender and sender becomes receiver. This whole process once again takes place, and that is why it is called as communication cycle. I hope that this concept will be understood all of you. We will discuss in our next lecture.